So we'll have a look at how virtual memory works. So here is a CPU, here is some RAM, and here is some secondary storage, could be a hard drive or maybe a solid state drive. Now, as we know, data is taken from RAM and put into the CPU to be processed. Okay, now let's get a visual representation of RAM. Okay, so let's pretend this is RAM. Okay, now maybe we open up a program, maybe that program is like Word, for example. That will take up some memory in RAM. Okay, maybe we open up another program like PowerPoint. Okay, that takes up some more memory. Maybe we then open up an internet browser, that takes up some more memory. Okay, maybe then we open up a music player so we can play some music, that takes up some more memory. And maybe we open up a game, for example, that takes up some more memory. Now, the problem is we haven't got enough memory in RAM. Okay, we run out of memory. So therefore, we can't then open that extra program. Okay, so what virtual memory does is it looks at your RAM and it figures out what is the least used memory in RAM. Okay, what is the least used data in RAM? And what it will do is it will swap it back to the hard drive, okay, to create some space in RAM. So let's say we wanted to open up that game, and maybe like Word, just here, we haven't used Word for a while, okay? So in other words, it's running in the background, but we haven't used it. So what virtual memory does is it takes this block of memory, it puts it into the secondary storage temporarily, okay, to free up this block of memory. And this means that now when we open up the game, okay, the game can occupy this spot in our virtual memory. Okay, now let's say, for example, then that we finished playing the game and we wanted Word back up again. So what happens then is Word is then taken from secondary storage, something else is swapped out, maybe the game this time, okay, and Word is put back in, so then we can use Word. Okay, so the idea of virtual memory is that sections of RAM are swapped out back into the secondary storage and held there temporarily so there can be space in RAM for more programs to be open. So it allows quite effective multitasking. Okay, it allows us to open up several programs at a time. Now, the downside to virtual memory is it's quite slow. So this process here of swapping data into the secondary storage and swapping it back again is slow. And you may notice sometimes if you've got a lot of programs open on your computer or tablet or whatever, that the programs sometimes run slow or they take a while to come up. Okay, this may be the instance of virtual memory being used to swap the data back and forwards from the secondary storage into RAM. Okay, so it does have its disadvantages. Also, if you happen to be using a hard drive as your secondary storage, it can suffer from what's called disk thrashing, which means that the disk is working almost constantly, okay, to swap in and out memory into the virtual memory, into the RAM as virtual memory. Okay, now if the disk in the hard drive is working constantly, this obviously means it's more susceptible to wear and tear and may shorten the life of your hard drive. Okay, so virtual memory useful for having multiple programs open by swapping in and out data between virtual memory, between RAM and secondary storage. But disadvantages, it's slow and may make the life of your hard drive slightly less than it would already normally be.